Well, we will learn two parts. The first is the depreciation amount and how depreciation affects income tax. And the second part in the income tax. And we know how income tax affects the economic decision making. Okay. So far, we have to some the decision, okay, economic decision. But we do not concern about income tax in this chapter. We have to concern about income tax before to make decision. Okay. But we have to examine the cash flow. The cash flow now we call it the after tax cash flow. That means we have to concern about the income tax into the cash flow. The income tax usually represents a significant cash outflow. Remember the cash outflow, okay? And we have the inflow and outflow. Income tax usually represent the cash outflow, okay? And in which depreciation is an important element in the after-tax cash flow. So the first, we have to find depreciation amount, okay? So what depreciation? Depreciation is the decrease in value of physical property with the passage of time or use, okay? Over time or over production units, okay? Depreciation is the accounting concept. It's a non-cash cost, okay? Established by the annual deduction, again, before tax income. Okay, so now we have to examine some method to find depreciation. If you want to get depreciation, we have to evaluate some property. What property is depreciable? The property is depreciable if it is used in the business. Remember, if you want to get a depreciation amount, your property or your asset have to use in business, and the useful life longer than 1 year. Each useful life longer than 1 year, okay? And it's not inventory, okay? It's not inventory, that means your property will be used in business, okay? Depreciable property is tangible or intangible. Tangible is very easy. You can see the assets, for example, infrastructure in personal, for example, the laptop, something we can see in our room, for example, in your room, classroom, you see the laptop. Laptop projector, something, table and chair and something, that is tangible. Okay, we can get depreciation about that. And the intangible is the copyright, patent, franchise, something. And depreciable property, it depreciates according to the depreciation schedule, but on some method, and when it is put in service. Always remember that if you want to get depreciation amount, your property, your assets have to be put in service. Okay, that means you use it in business. And here it is some method we use to find depreciation amount. Okay, the first is stretched line, SL method. We call the SL method. That is the classical depreciation method. The stretched line, that means the content amount. Remember that the stretched line, the content amount of depreciation each year over the depreciable line. Okay, we call the useful line now depreciable line of the asset. We follow some information here, some formula here. The first DK, that means depreciation in year K, is going to be, B is the cost basic, minus surplus value at the end of year N, divide for N of year. Year is the depreciable line, okay, depreciable line. This DK star, that means the cumulative depreciation. They're going to K multiply for DK, okay? K is the number of year, okay? K less than or equal to N, greater than equal to 1 year, okay? Book value, BV equal to cost basis minus for the accumulative depreciation in year K, end of year K, okay? So now, you can see the example for your understanding. The larger tool had a cost basis of $200,000 and a 5-year depreciable life. Estimate surplus value of the laser is $20,000 at the end of 5 years. Determine the annual depreciation amount using SL method and tabulate the annual depreciation amount and the book value. Okay. You see, you can find the depreciation amount first. Apply this formula. You can see the any K, for example, K equal to 3. That means in year 3, D3 equal to B. B is the cost basis 200,000 here, minus surplus value. Surplus value at the end of year 5 is 20,000 here, and then divide for 5 years. N is the 5 years. 5 year depreciable life, okay? So you have the depreciation amount, $36,000, okay? And the cumulative depreciation until 3 years, according to the this here, K multiply for DK, okay? K is 3, because K now is the cumulative, the end of year 3, okay? So K is 3. Multiply for D3 and you have 108,000, okay? The book value, the end of year 3, is going to be minus for D3 star. And the book value, the end of year 3, is 92,000, okay? And then you can tabulate the amount here. You have 5 years. From 0 to 5, okay? End of year 0 to 5. In year 0, that means the laser have no push in the service, so depreciation is 0. We follow the trend here. Okay? It is used in the business, okay? Used in the business. But in the year 0, we have no business, so the D0 is 0. So the book value up the end of year 0 is equal to the cost basis, 200,000, okay? And then in the year 1 to year 5, we call it the contained amount of a year. So any year from 1 to 5, we have the same amount of 36,000, okay? And then the book value at the end of year 1, according to the book value in the year 0, minus for depreciation year 1, and you had a book value 1. In book value 2, according to the book value 1, minus for depreciation, you get here. Okay? And book value 3, according to book value 2, minus for depreciation, and you have here. And you can check the accumulative depreciation of year 3, okay? It is the total from year 1 to year 3. And 108,000. Okay. You got this? Any question? I see some chat. Okay. What's your job here? What's your question here? I cannot see your question. Yeah, here. Thầy zoom lên được. Ok. Teacher, what is meaning of the book value and the song bad value in Vietnamese? Ok. Song bad value. Song bad value is the value remaining the end of useful life. We already learned in the chapter 4 and the in the chapter 1, okay? You remember? Trinh Nguyễn, book value and the sum vet value, we already learned in the chapter 1, okay? And chapter 4, he made it clearly in the chapter 4. This is the accounting concept. Sum vet value in Vietnamese, that means giá trị còn lại, song vét là giá trị tiết kiệm được, nên giá trị mà bạn còn lại của các tài sản đó vào cuối cái thời đoạn cái đời sống của nó. The song vét value may be equal to the book value. Book value is the value of the property the end of year K. It is the accounting concept. Book value là cái giá trị sổ sách, cái giá trị mà nó theo cái sổ sách tính toán thôi, nó không có thật. Ví dụ như là mình khấu hao cái tài sản đó qua hàng năm, thì ở cuối năm thứ K nào đó, thì nó còn lại cái tài sản là dự tính, nó còn cái giá trị như vậy, và người ta có thể ví dụ như ngừng, sau khi mà họ ngừng cái dự án ở 5 năm, thì cái giá trị của cái tài sản cái đó còn lại ở năm thứ năm là bao nhiêu? Book value số kế. Vũ Trường Giang, Trinh Nguyễn. Ok, you got this? Thank you. Here, I get it bigger for you. Trinh, Lê Thúy Quỳnh, you can see it. You got it? Any question here? Any question here? If you follow the straight line method, the depreciation amount is the content amount, okay? The content amount of a year. So you can find it in every year. It DK, it D minus sum vet value divide for N. Sum vet value is the value of the asset the end of daylight, okay? So here you can see the estimate sum vet value of laser is 22,000. It's the end of year 5. Year 5 also the depreciable line. Okay. So the sum vet value here now is equal to 20,000. Okay. And the book, the cost basic is 200 here, and divide for n. N is 5-year depreciable life. And you have the content amount over year is 36,000 within 5 year. 5 year depreciable life. Okay. Here. Okay. And you get the book value here. Okay, and the cumulative depreciation amount. Okay, get it? Okay, thank you. And then now we go to another. You can solve it. Okay, declining balance DD. Different with the SL method. In this method, we have the constant percentage of the remaining book value. It depreciates a year. And you follow this formula to find the depreciation amount of a year, the cumulative depreciation amount, DK star, and the book value. Okay? You remember that R, big R, Big R is the equal to 2 divide N when they give you R equal to 200% declining balance. Okay. And if you use the 150%, R equal to 1.5 divide for N. Okay. And now you read this example for your understanding. The electric saw for cutting small piece of lumber in the furniture manufacturing plant had a cost basis of $4,000 and a 10-year depreciable life. The estimated solvent value of the saw at the end of year 10 is zero. That means the end of year 10, this electric saw have $0. Okay. Use the DB method to calculate the annual depreciation amount when R is equal to 2 divide N. That means 200% and R is equal to 1.5 divide N. That means 150%. And then tabulate the annual depreciation amount and book value for each year. Okay. Okay. So we follow this formula to find depreciation. For example, I want to find that year at year six. At year six for the A is the R equal to 200%. So R equal to 0.2. Okay. And D6 equal to B multiply for 1 minus R power K minus 1. That means K equal to 6, so K minus 1 is 5. Multiply for R. So you follow it and you have the D6 equal to $262. Okay? And D6 star, that means cumulative depreciation at the end of year 6. You follow here. B time for 1 minus total of 1 minus R power K. And you have this. Okay. B is 400. 1 minus 1 minus R power 6 equal to here. $2,950. Cumulative depreciation the end of year 6. Okay. And book value of 6. Book value of 6 equal to B minus 1 minus R power 6. And you have the $1,048. Okay. And then you can use this formula for any K from 1 to 10. Okay, for 1 to 10. And you have this table. This table. This table is tabulated for the 200%, okay? The question A. Same in year zero, you have no service, so DK is zero, and you have the book value in the year zero is equal to the cost basis, okay? Equal to cost basis, and then in year one, you follow this formula D1, you can find 800. So the book value of year one equal to the book value in year zero minus for the D1, and you have here. Okay, and the same you continue to do in D2, D3, D4, D5, and D6, you can see here, D6. And the book value of D6, B6 here, okay. D6 star is total, the sum of them from 1 to 6, okay. 1 to 6 is the 2,951. Okay, and you continue to do to year 10, okay? In here, the end of year 10, you can see the book value is remaining 429. Different with the sum value of the end of year 10 is zero, okay? In this case, on the accounting system. The electric saw had the $429, but in the solvent value is zero. Okay, so it's different. Sometimes it's different, and sometimes it's equal. For example, here. In the first one, you can see the solvent value, the end of the depreciable life is 20,000. The book value also the 20,000. So you can see the book value sometimes equal to the solvent value. Decay, not equal. And then you can continue to develop for the B, okay? The B. R equal to 1.5 divided for N. That means 0.15. And you continue to find D6 here, D6 star here, and B book value 6, at the end of 6 in here. And you continue to develop the table with the question B, okay? B2. You do it. Okay? You understand? Let's see one. You got it? Hello, let's see one. It's okay, clear. Lê Đình Khánh. Hello, Lê Đình Khánh.
Yes, I understand.
Okay, it's clear, huh? Thank you. And now we continue to another method we call it unit of production. The unit of production. It can be used when the degree in the value of asset is mostly a function of use in this of time, okay? In the first, you can see that here. Depreciation, that means degree in value of the physical property with the basis of time or use, okay? The first two methods we can examine in the basis of time, okay? And the third method, unit of production, we will examine in the basis of use. Okay. The three methods. Yeah? The third method, the unit of production, is the function of use in terms of time. So the cost basis is allocated equally over number of units produced over asset line. Okay, the useful line, the depreciable line. The depreciation amount per unit of production is found by this formula. B minus solvent value divided for the estimated production is, okay, underlying time. So you can read the example for your understanding. Here, a B of equipment used in business had a basic of $50,000 and is expected to have the 10,000 solvent value when replaced after 30,000 hour of use. Okay, 5 depreciation rate per hour of use and 5 book value after 10,000 hour of operation. Okay, the first you can find the depreciation per unit of production. Okay, depreciation rate per hour. Unit of production now is the hour of use, okay? And here, the book value, the cost basis is the $50,000. Solvent value after 30,000 hour of use is the $10,000. And divide for the production unit in this example is 30,000 hour of use, okay? This equipment used for 30,000 hours. Okay, so you have $1.33 per hour of use. Okay, per hour of use. And then after 10,000 hours of use, the book value is going to the cost basis minus for the $1.33 per hour multiplied for 10,000 hours. So you have the $36,700 after 10,000 hour of use. Okay, this is the question. Thank you. You got it, huh? It's very easy. So, but the third method is a classical method. But now you go to the modern method. We call the modified accelerated cost recovery. MACRS in abbreviation. This method is the principal method for computing depreciation for property in engineering project, any engineering project. In practice, we use MACRS. This method consists of two systems. One is ZDS and another is ADS, okay? General Depreciation System or Alternative Depreciation System. All of them, we have to consider over five steps. First, you define cost basis, okay? The second, that a property was placed into service ongoing, okay? In the classical method also, we have to define that a property was placed into service because depreciation will be counted when we put our property in service. And define property class or recovery periods, okay? And then you define what method we use, ZDS or ADS. And the time convention that apply, okay? Half year, remember here, okay? And then this is the diagram when we use the ZDS or ADS. Based on day requirement, you can use the ZDS or ADS. If you use the ZDS, you have to define the recovery periods. Okay, recovery periods back on the table 7.2. If they give you the asset description or the table 7.4, if they give you the graph line, okay, and then you follow the table 7.3 to find the recovery rate and recovery period. Okay, recovery period first, and then find recovery rest back on the table 7.3. And then you compute the depreciation deduction in year K back on the formula. DK equal to RK time for B, okay? And if you use the ADS, that require you to use the ADS, the same, you can follow the table 7.2 to ascertain the recovery period, and then compute the HL depreciation based on the HL formula, okay? The asset cost basis defined for recovery periods in the HL, the first method you only learn, okay? And then you compute the depreciation deduction in year K. If K equal to 1, you get 0.5, 50% of HL. 50% of HL amount. And from D2 to DN, it equal to the HL, 100% of HL amount. And depreciation amount of year N plus 1 equal to 50% of HL, equal to D1, okay? Yes. Follow this diagram, we have to solve some problem. Don't worry, okay? The MACRS is very easy. The first, you can follow the table 7.2. And then you follow the 7.3 to find the recovery rate, RK. And then you follow the formula to find the depreciation amount, okay? Okay. For your understand, you reach this example, MCARS depreciation with ZDS. They require you to use the ZDS. For example, the firm purchased and placed in service a new piece of semiconductor manufacturing equipment. Remember, semiconductor, okay? The cost basis of equipment is $100,000. Determine the depreciation charge in the 4 years. Book value the end of 4 years. Cumulative depreciation through third year. And book value the end of fifth year. If equipment disposed at that time, that means The end of fifth year, we stop this project. Okay, we will sell out this semiconductor equipment. Okay, you follow this here. They require you to use GDX. So the first step, you have to use the table 7.2 to find recovery periods. What the recovery periods for this example? Okay, from the table 7.2, you can see the semiconductor equipment belong to the electronics, okay, electronics class. So they have the class life of 6 years and recovery period of 5 years for ZDX. And you can see here. Okay, you can see this table here. You can see in your textbook, okay? And here you can see the table 7.2. The semiconductor, you find the semiconductor equipment, tức là thiết bị bán dẫn, đúng không? Thì nó thuộc về điện tử, đây, các sản phẩm điện tử, electronic component, product and system, các sản phẩm, các thành phần hoặc là hệ thống điện tử. Nó thuộc về cái nhóm này. Do đó, cái glass line và GDS là cái cột thứ 4-5 này của cái nhóm electronic component là 6 year, glass line is 6 year and GDS 5 year. Okay? You can get it, huh? Table 2, 7.2. Compared to the your slide. You see here? Depreciation. From the table 7.2, you can see the semiconductor equipment has a class life of 6 years and the ZDX recovery of 5 years. Okay, and then with the 5 year in the ZDX recovery, you go to the table 7.3 to find the recovery rate. Okay, recovery rate. What the 7.3? Here. Yeah, it's 7.3. You see in the textbook, okay? 7.3. Okay. And the ZDX recovery rate here for the 5 year. You remember in the 7.2, ZDX of 5 years. So you choose this column, 5 year. Okay. And then the RK for any K, R1 is 0.2, R2 0.32, R3 0.192, R4 and 5 0.1152, and R6 0.0576. Okay, remember R4 0.1152, okay? That means the recovery rate of year 4, okay? Recovery rate of year 4 and recovery rate of year 5 is same value, 0.1152, okay? And come back to your example. Here. The question A, they ask you depreciation in the 4 year, that means D4, okay? They require you to find the D4. So here, the question A. D4 equal to the R4, okay? R4 time 4, cost basis. R4, you remember in the table 7.3, 0.1152, time for 100,000. So the depreciation in year 4, D4 is 11,520, okay? The question A. Okay. Question B. Book value the end of year 4. Book, that means DV4. DV4 equal to the cost basic minus for the the D4 star, that means the cumulative depreciation in 4 years, from year 1, year 2, year 3, and year 4. In the table 7.3, you have the R1 is 0.2, R2 is 0.32, R3 and R4, okay? And all of them multiply for 100,000. It's the D4 star, okay? You remember D4 star. And then you have the BV4, 17,280. Okay? You got it? The question say, the cumulative depreciation throughout third year, that means D3 star, okay? D4 is here, D4 star here. So D3 star only from year 1, year 2, year 3, okay? Here you have. Year 1, year 2, year 3, multiplied of God basic. And D3 star will be 71,200. Okay, you got it? Any question? You got it? Minh Quân, how about you? Hello, Minh Quân. You got it? It's clear, huh? Lê Anh Kha, how about you?
Sir.
You understand?
Yes, I got it.
Okay, so we continue to the question D, huh? Question A is okay. So ABC is very easy, but now question D. Why D3 star include D3? Yes, include D3 because D3 star, that means the cumulative from year 1 to year 3. So it includes the depreciation in year 1. Okay, depreciation in year 1, plus for depreciation in year 2, plus for depreciation in year 3. Đặng Dung, you got this? Hello, Đặng Dung. Mm-hmm. Yes. D3 star, okay, D3 star is the cumulative, okay, depreciation from year 1 to year 3. Okay, and now we solve the question D. Question D is the difficult. BV, book value the end of fifth year, if equipment is disposed at that time. But you can see in the question A, equipment had class life of six years. Okay, that means we have to stop this equipment the end of 6 years. But now we stop it in the end of fifth year. That means we have to stop it soon, 1 year soon. Okay, 1 year soon. If the question D, only find the book value the end of fifth year, you follow the procedure same the question D. Question B, book value of 4 years. Here, book value of 4 years. You get book value of 4 minus for the depreciation in year 5, okay? And then you have the book value 5. But now we stop the project. That means we have to here dispose the equipment. That means we have to stop the project sooner 1 year. Okay, so depreciation deduction in year 5 than only 50%. Okay, you remember depreciation in year 5 you can find by the R5, okay, time for both got basic, okay, here R5 from the table of 7.3 you have the R5 0.1152, okay, and multiply for this got basic and you have all of depreciation in year 5. If this equipment it continue to use until 5-6, but now we stop it, okay, dispose the equipment, so we have to stop 1 year sooner, okay, year 5 to year 6, okay, but now you can you only go to year 5 and then you stop it, that means the depreciation deduction only 50%, so you multiply for 0.5. you understand this? And then deduction depreciation now have only 5,760, and then you can find the book value of year 5 equal to the book value of year 4 minus for depreciation of year 5, okay, and now the book value of year 5, the end of year 5 is 11,520. Hiểu không? Do you understand? Dung đẳng. Yes. Sure. Yes. Yes, sure. Dung đẳng. Because we stop the project 1 year sooner. Nói tiếng Việt hả? Ok. Nguyễn Đăng Khoa. Thì bây giờ tôi nói nè. Cái các bạn nhìn thấy trong cái câu đầu á, cái class line của cái thiết bị này là 6 năm lận, đúng không? Nếu như mà người ta đặt câu hỏi rằng là tìm cái book value của cuối năm thứ năm thì bình thường thôi, giống y câu B, bạn tính theo cái book value của năm thứ năm thì bằng book value của năm thứ bốn trừ cho depreciation của năm thứ năm, đúng không? Thì cái giống như câu B nè, bằng book value của năm thứ, bằng cái cost basic nè trừ cho cái depreciation của suốt 4 năm từ năm 1 đến năm thứ 4 và ra được là book value của năm thứ 4, thì năm thứ 5 cũng vậy, nếu như là cứ bình thường thì cứ bằng là cái cost basic trừ cho cái depreciation cumulative của toàn bộ của năm thứ 1 đến năm thứ 5, nhưng hoặc có thể bạn lấy book value của thứ 5 bằng book value của năm thứ 4 này trừ cho depreciation của năm thứ 5, mà depreciation của năm thứ 5 là bằng gì? Bằng, nó giống như D4 vậy, nó bằng cái R5 nhân cho cost basic, đúng không? R5 bằng R4 cho nên nó bằng đúng 11.520 này. Thì nếu như mà bình thường đó thì bạn lấy cái book value của năm thứ 4 trừ cho cái depreciation của năm thứ 5 thì ra cái book value của năm thứ 5. Tuy nhiên cái câu này nó khác là bởi vì tại năm thứ 5 đó người ta muốn kết thúc cái dự án này luôn, không chạy tới năm thứ 6, tức là nghỉ trước 1 năm, đúng không ạ? Nghỉ trước 1 năm, do đó là ví dụ năm thứ 5 này, năm thứ 6 này, hai, có nghĩa rằng chạy năm thứ 5, năm thứ 6 thì 2 năm nữa mới hết cái cuộc sống của cái dự án này. Nhưng mà thứ 5 là bạn họ muốn kết thúc luôn, tại vì dispose này, dispose cái này ngay tại năm thứ 5 luôn này. Do đó nó chỉ còn 50% thôi. Nó chỉ 50%, tại vì lẽ ra là phải 2 năm, năm thứ 5, năm thứ 6 đúng không ạ? Thì bây giờ mình mới năm năm kết thúc thì mới có đạt được cái 50%. Do đó cái depreciation của năm thứ 5 là phải chỉ có 50% của cái lượng lẽ ra nó có là đây như thế này. Hiểu không? Do đó cái depreciation năm của năm thứ năm chỉ là 50% của cái lượng bình thường, bởi vì mình đã kết thúc rồi đó. Do đó thì cái book value của nó sẽ tăng cao hơn, book value của năm thứ năm nó sẽ cao hơn. Nghĩa rằng là người ta phải dự toán cái giá trị book value này nè, để khi kết thúc dự án người ta sẽ estimate cái giá trị đó và người ta có thể bán ra thị trường cái giá ở đâu quanh quanh đây, đúng không nào? Cái solvent value có thể nó bằng book value, cũng có thể nó hơn, cũng có thể nó ít hơn. Okay, you got it, Đăng Khoa, and all of you. Đăng Khoa. Yeah, Dung Đặng, if you stop it sooner, 2 years. 2 years, for example, year four, okay? Year four, that means you cannot reduce 25. You reduce 33% because 4, 5, and 6. 3 years. 4, 5, and 6, and you stop in year 4. That means you got only 30%. Okay, 33%. Yes, yes, 1.3. 1 divided for 3. Yes. Thank you. Okay, so the question D, we have to thinking about it a little bit, huh? If it follow the class line, it's no problem. We follow the procedure. If we stop before class line, we have to consider about it. Thank you. Any question? Lê Thúy Quỳnh, how about you?
It's okay, teacher.
Okay, thank you. So, another question is another example. We examine the ADS, okay? The ADS. Here, the large manufacturer of 6 metal products. You remember metal products. In midway betray and plant in service, a new modern computer control flexible manufacturing system with $3 million. Okay. Because this company would not be profitable until the new technology had been plant in several years, it elect to utilize the ADS under MACI. Anything information to make clear the why we use the ADS also only. Okay, so you read it to understand why we use that. They use the ADS. Thus, the company could not slow down its depreciation allowance in hope of postponing its income tax advantage until it becomes a profitable concern on the major, to make sure why we use the ADS. What depreciation deduction can be claimed for the new system? Yeah. Here. Follow this ADS procedure. The first, you go to the table 7.2 to find the recovery periods, okay? And then compute the SL and follow this formula for 8 years. Year one, 50% of SL. Year two to year N, equal to 100% of SL. Year N plus one, 50% of SL, okay? SL is the first method we only learn. So here. From the table 7.2, you have ADS recovery period for manufacturer of fabric cast metal product in 10 year. Okay, 10 year. So under ADS, we find the SL method, okay? With no solvents, okay? Follow the SL method you have here. 3 million divided for 10 because solvent is zero. So you have this solvent amount, okay? So the depreciation in year one, D1 is 50% of SL, 50% of SL. So the D1 is 125,000. Year 13 also, year 13 is 50%. So here, from year two to year end, it's the tail. So you have the 100 up here, SL. So you have 250,000 per year. And compared to the table to find why they define exactly here in 10 years. Here. The fabric, you find any in the table 7.2, the metal. Metal six. Fabric here, okay. Manufacture of fabric metal product, okay. So glass light is 12 and ADS of 12. Okay. ADS of 12. Okay. So they define exactly the recovery period now is the 12 year. Okay. Glass light of. Thank you. Any question? You follow us?
Teacher, can yes. you explain more about when to use ADS and when to use GDS? Yes.
Who are you?
I'm Khánh Linh.
Ah, Khánh Linh.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm not very clear about that.
Yeah, but on the requirement, okay? But on the requirement, I require you to use the ADS or the GDS. And if you are the experts, you can risk the information and you can advise the company to use the ZDS or ADS. The ZDS is the kernel depreciation system, and the ADS, the alternative depreciation system. So for example, this example, they use the ADS. Because if you are the experts, okay, you can see that why we use the ADS. Because we have to postpone depreciation until they have the profitable. That's the alternative. So in this case, companies should follow the ADS better than the ZDS. Okay, but you have no knowledge to define exactly how to use the ADS and ZDS. So you follow the requirement, okay? In the simple ways. You got it, Helen?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah. Yes, so and you can see in the example, they upload many information, any information, and to use the ADS and CD, MACIS, to compute the depreciation deduction. Yeah, trong thực tế các bạn, tức là các chuyên gia sẽ xem thử là trong cái trường hợp của công ty của mình á, trong cái business của mình á, nó có những cái đặc trưng nào, thì chúng ta sẽ sử dụng các cái hệ thống tính toán cái khấu hao đó của tài sản của chúng ta bằng cái phương pháp nào là tối ưu nhất, bởi vì lát nữa các bạn thấy mình tính cái depreciation nó tác động rất lớn vào trong cái dòng tiền và nó giảm cái chi phí chịu thuế của doanh nghiệp. Do đó người ta sẽ dùng cái phương pháp nào mà tối ưu nhất cho doanh nghiệp, nhưng mà không nhất thiết phải là một cái phương pháp đó cho toàn bộ cái hoạt động của doanh nghiệp đâu, mà có thể trong giai đoạn này người ta dùng cái phương pháp này, nhưng trong giai đoạn khác, ví dụ hay là sản phẩm này người ta dùng phương pháp này, sản phẩm khác người ta dùng phương pháp khác. Ví dụ như là ở trong trường IU chẳng hạn, vì khi khấu hao các cái thiết bị bàn ghế máy móc thì có thể là dùng phương pháp container amount, đơn giản classical cho nó đơn giản, ví dụ vậy. Nhưng mà có một số doanh nghiệp khác người ta dùng cái phương pháp khác. Nên là ví dụ như trong trường hợp này nè, các bạn thấy nè, người ta giải thích rất là nhiều thứ, bởi vì cái thiết bị này nó dùng cho cái hệ thống sản xuất linh hoạt mà, và nó rất là mắc tiền và công ty chưa thể có lợi nhuận gì cả, trừ khi mà họ có được cái công nghệ mới được sử dụng trong vài năm sau đó thì nó mới có lời, thì lúc đó người ta để tận dụng utilize, là tận dụng cái hệ thống ADS để có thể là tính toán cái depreciation deduction. Okay, keep you. And anything information you have to adjust in the economics and the tax, and you can advise the company to use any system. Thank you, Khanlin. Question. It's very good question. But advanced study, okay. Okay, the first basic depreciation I already introduced for you, and now we go to the income tax. Okay. Income tax, what the income tax? Income tax, as I said, is the function of gross revenue. Okay, function of gross revenue minus allowable expense. Okay. So you have to define exactly before tax and after tax MARR. Okay. Also, the only the after tax MIRR lower than before tax MIRR. So far, we examine any cash flow in the before tax. Okay, you remember, we have no concern about the depreciation. Okay, and now from now on, we have to examine any cash flow with the depreciation amount. So we have to find the after tax cash flow. Okay, after tax. So okay, and then we have some information to use to find the WACC. WACC, that mean the weight of record of capital. Weight is a record of capital. Okay. And the very important in this part, we have to define the taxable income. Taxable income. In Vietnamese, it's the thu nhập chịu thuế. Any business firm, any company, to define exactly the taxable income. They are taxable income. All the taxable income we can find by the gross income minus for all expense. Okay, but you remember expense, not capital investment. Okay. And minus for depreciation deduction. So if you have the depreciation deduction, so you reduce the taxable income for your company. Okay. So the depreciation is very important for their business operation. Okay. And you read the example to understand the taxable income, how to find the taxable income. A company generate a 1,500,000 of gross income, okay, during its tax year and incurs operating expense of $800,000. Property tax in business assess amount to $48,000. Total depreciation deduction for tax year equal to $114,000. What is taxable income? Okay, you follow this formula to find here. The first is gross income here, 1,500,000, and deduct own expense. The first expense is the operating expense. Okay, the second expense is the property tax, business asset amount. Okay. And the depreciation amount here, depreciation. Okay, so you have the only $538,000 for tax, okay, for income tax. Okay, the next, if you have to find the sum effective corporate income tax rate, that means the federal rate and state rate. Okay. But now we are in Vietnam. So you read it for understand only. We're not in the American system, okay? We're in Vietnam. We have no federal and state tax. Okay? You read it for your understand only. Gain and loss of disposal of an asset, gain or loss. You remember, so far, I said that sometime book value echo to the market value. The market value, sometimes we call it the solvent value, okay? So it's sometimes different, sometimes echo. So what if the market value greater than book value, we gain this portion, okay? And if the market value less than book value, we lost, okay? Hiểu không? Ví dụ như khi mình kết thúc cái dự án đó, cái giá trị mình bán cái máy đó ra thị trường gọi là market value, giá trị thị trường, MV. Còn cái BV này là cái giá trị trong sổ sách, cái book value mình hồi nãy giờ mình nói là accounting concept, nó là một khái niệm về sổ sách, về kế toán thôi, nó không có giá trị thực tế. À, thì để tham khảo để ra cái market value này, sometimes cái book value này nó bằng cái solvent value hay là cái market value, và sometimes nó lớn hơn hoặc nhỏ hơn. Thì nếu như cái market value này mà lớn hơn thì mình đang thu được lợi gain, ok. Còn nếu cái market value nó nhỏ hơn book value thì mình bị loss, vậy thôi. Hiểu thêm về các bạn đọc thêm cái ví dụ 7.11. The very important part in this income tax, we have to define the after tax cash flow. We have to focus here. After tax cash flow from now on, or any analysis. Economic analysis, we have to use after-tax cash flow, after-tax MARR, intake of before-tax cash flow. So far, in chapter 4, chapter 5, chapter 6, we use the before-tax cash flow, okay? And now on, we have to consider the after-tax cash flow. So before to find after-tax cash flow, we have to make aquatic with some notation here. Revenue, okay, expense, depreciation amount, effective income tax rate, okay, and the BT is the income tax, BTK, income tax, the sequence during year, and the TCF is the after-tax cash flow during UK. So taxable income, we only learn by the revenue, gross revenue, minus expense, own expense, and minus for the depreciation amount, okay, taxable income. The ordinary income tax constituent, BT, equal to the effective income tax rate, T, minus T, multiply for the taxable income, okay? Yes, you understand, very easy to understand this, this is the thu nhập chịu thuế, cái lượng thu nhập chịu thuế này này, mình nhân vào cho cái tỷ lệ thuế. Effective income tax rate là small t này. Minus nó đi, nó gọi là cái thuế thu nhập, này, cái lượng thuế thu nhập. And before tax cash flow equal to R minus E only here. Before tax cash flow. From now on, we have to examine after tax cash flow. After tax cash flow equal to before tax cash flow plus for BT income tax consumer. Okay. Here. So we change something here and you have the after tax cash flow equal to 1 minus T time for R minus E. Plus for T, D, okay, yeah, easy, huh? And you can follow this as procedure to build the after tax cap here. Here, so far we learn only the before tax cap flow. For the cash flow from year zero to year end. At the year end, we had a market value. Sometimes we call the solvent value. Okay, market value, solvent value. Okay. At the year zero, we had a capital investment. Okay, you remember? And from year one to year end, we have some revenue expense something here. It may be positive or negative. Okay. If the inflow is positive, at the outflow is negative, okay. And at the end of the end, we had a market value. It's very, very familiar with the cash flow before tax cash flow. All of you can understand it, huh? Yes. And then now we have to consider more about depreciation deduction. You remember that depreciation will be have when we boost our property in service. So in year zero, we have no depreciation. Okay. From year one to year end, we have depreciation amount. Okay. This always positive inside. Okay. Positive. So the company would want to make the depreciation. Okay. It's positive. In the question, the column B. The column C. Column C, what is here? It's a taxable income. TI, huh? Equal to A minus B, A minus B. So you have here, TI can be negative or positive, okay? TI sometimes it's negative, sometimes it's positive. Yes, they call B, depend on here, okay? And now we have a MV minus BV because you have the taxable income. Now the book value happen, okay? And the MV minus BV, the end of year end, you have the MV minus BV. Okay, and then column D, the cash flow for income tax, okay, income tax here, BT. BT equal to minus T, time for TI, time for taxable income here, taxable income, okay. Minus T time for taxable income, so we have TI. Minus T time for TI, okay? It opposite inside from TI, okay? If TI is negative, it is positive. If TI is positive, it is negative, okay? So you have multiply for minus T here, minus T here. Mm-hmm. And then the last column, you have find the after tax cash flow. Okay, equal to A plus D, A plus D. So the capital investment is here. Capital investment plus zero, so you have a capital investment. Okay, and the ordinary come here, plus for here, and you have after tax flow. Okay, MV, left for minus T, MV minus PV. And you have the end of EN. EN, you have this component. This is the after-tax cash flow. Okay, you got it? That means the first you have to find depreciation. And then you find asset taxable income. Then on the effective income tax rate, you find the cash flow for income tax consumer meeting. Okay. And you get all of them together and you have an after tax cash flow. That means the after tax cash flow, you already consider the income tax, the depreciation. Okay, for your understand, you follow the example. The admin company purchase a pump for 250,000 and spend 20,000 for shipping and installation. The addition of this pump will result in the increase of revenue of $80,000 with associated increase expense of $10,000 a year. This pump follow the GDS, okay? Follow the GDS, they give you the information, deduction, depreciation deduction, okay? For with the recovery period of 5 years, huh? 5 years. At main effective tax rate is 41%. T, huh? Small T. What is the after-tax cash flow for this project? For 4 years. Okay, and you follow this formula to find after tax here. The cost basic is what here between cost and the shipping and installation cost. Get all of them, and you have the 270. Okay, before tax cash flow equal to R minus E. What are R revenue? It's here. And E is the expense is 10, and you're 70, okay? Before, you follow the GDS, okay? The GDS with the 5 years, they give you already, and you follow the table 7.3, huh? No need to go to 7.2, because now they only give you all information, the depreciation. GDS with the recovery of 5 years, so you go to the table 7.3, okay, to find the depreciation year 4, okay, R4, 0.1152, multiply for cost basic here, and you have $31,000, okay. Mm-hmm. And the income tax consequent, minus T, T is effective income tax rate, 41%. That means 0.41 multiply for R minus E minus D. Okay, because after that we have to consider more about the depreciation in year 4. Okay, we get it, and then it's the minus 15,900. So after tax cash flow at year 4 is going to be for tax cash flow in year 4 plus for T4. And T4 here, and you get the after tax cash flow here for $54,000. You got this? Any question? Hello, any question? You follow me?
Thầy ơi.
Yeah.
Em thấy cái D4 thầy làm tròn đúng không thầy?
À, D4 hả?
Dạ, 31.104 mà ở dưới có 31 và cái này là...
làm tròn đó, tôi làm tròn thôi. À, dạ. Khi mà đánh chả gõ chữ rồi đó.
Dạ, em cảm ơn thầy.
Có thể các bạn viết ra cho nó đầy đủ. Ha? Có thể khi tôi đánh chữ nó không có... Ok? Tôi sửa lại luôn để cho... Ủa đâu dữ vậy nè? Ok. Any question? Any question? Okay, huh? And then we go to the economic value as EVA. The EVA is the estimate of profit earning potential of proposed capital investment in engineering project. It's very easy to find. Huh? You follow the information. The EVA, huh? The EVA economic value as equal to the net operating profit after tax. In UK, minus for I time for BV, book value, the cost of my capital in UK. Okay. Book value K minus one minus for I. Okay. In which I is after tax MIR. Okay. You consider that after tax MIR, but on the cost of basic. And then the net operating profit after tax in UK equal to the R plus E minus D. Time for 1 minute T, okay. And equal to the after tax cash flow minus D. Okay. And then you can follow this example to understand. Follow the admin example. What the EVA for year four? If the after tax MIR is 8%, that means I equal to I 8%. So the net operating profit after tax is here. Okay, you can follow it. The after tax 4 minus D4 here. After tax 4 minus D4. And the after tax you already get here. 54,000. And minus for D4, 31,000. And you have the 22,900. Okay. And then you get the EVA, the economic value X here. By this number, minus for I. Time for BV K minus one is 4, minus one is 3, okay? And you have guess I is 0.08 here, okay? And the BV three you find in the depreciation. Equal to the R3, follow the table 7.3, multiple cost basic, and you have 70,700, and you get EVA of 16,700. Okay. Any question? And then, in summary for the chapter 7, we have two parts. The first, we have to define the depreciation amount based on some methods in which we have I introduce you three classical methods and one modified method, okay? The modern method is in which includes GDS or ADS. Okay? You follow them to find the depreciation. The second part is very important. So now on, we have to consider after tax cash flow. That means we have to see the depreciation effect to the cash flow, okay? And then to construct the after-tax cash flow and find something in this. That's all for this chapter, okay? And I already give you the exercise, okay? And if you do this, and remember to submit in the blackboard in time, 1 week later, okay? And I remind all of you, you have to solve it. And then you remember, if you try many times and then you cannot understand, please bring your problem to the review week, okay? And if you want to get my advice sooner, you have to send me your solution, okay? I can find what you wrong and I can advise you soon. If not, you can bring to the review with, okay? I will review for you. Thank you. Any question? The, huh? have no question. You got it?
Thầy ơi, với cái dạng bài này là mình không cần vẽ cash flow đúng không thầy?
Ừ, thì bây giờ thì chắc không cần đâu, tại vì là mình đã quen quá rồi, đúng không? Ừ, không cần đâu. Có những cái bài nào yêu cầu thì mình làm, nhưng có những bài đặc biệt người ta yêu cầu thì mình làm.
Dạ, em cảm ơn thầy.
Rồi. Linh phải không?
Dạ.
Ừ. Rồi, ok, còn ai có ý kiến, có câu hỏi gì nữa không nào? Các bạn cố gắng lên nha. Ừ. Hôm nay chúng ta có 50 sinh viên à. À, lớp mình có bao nhiêu sinh viên á nhỉ? Thảo Linh ơi. Thảo Linh đi ngủ rồi hả? Chà, gầy gò nhỉ.
I'm here teacher.
Ok, lớp mình có bao nhiêu sinh viên?
Dạ. Yeah.
Lớp mình có mấy sinh viên nhỉ?
Dạ, 58 này. 58, 59 gì đó.
Okay. Hiện nay mình có 50. Các bạn đã chọn phương án nào chưa? Đi học như thế nào rồi? Các bạn sẽ chọn phương án off hay on đây?
Dạ, em là em chọn on.
Chọn nè. Lười biếng vô tại Sài Gòn rồi phải không?
Dạ, với cũng đang có việc ở quê thầy, chưa xong nên cũng chưa vô được luôn.
Ok, để cố gắng sắp xếp, ví dụ như mà không sắp xếp được thì vẫn tiếp tục on. Một bạn nào mà đã sắp xếp được thì nên vô offline nha. Thì trường không biết phương án tổ chức như thế nào để vừa on vừa off này. Có thể là họ sẽ trang bị một số các thiết bị ra khi đi dạy off thì người ta sẽ online luôn. Nhưng mà anyway thì là cái lịch vẫn như vậy nha. Tức là trong bây giờ mình tiết là tiết 3-4-5 hả? 4-5-6 của ngày thứ ba nha. Ok, if you have no any question, we stop here. See you next week. Goodbye.